أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وإذ أخذنا ميثاق بني إسرائيل لا تعبدون إلا الله وبالوالدين إحسانا وذي القربى واليتامى والمساكين وقولوا للناس حسنا وأقيموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة ثم توليتم إلا قليلا منكم وأنتم معرضون. وإذ أخذنا ميثاقكم لا تسفكون دماءكم ولا تخرجون أنفسكم من دياركم ثم أقررتم وأنتم تشهدون. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم ربنا ألهمنا رشدنا وعزنا من شرور أنفسنا. اللهم ارحمنا بالقرآن العظيم. اللهم اجعله لنا إماما ونورا وهدى ورحمة. اللهم ذكرنا منه ما نسينا وعلمنا منه ما جهلنا وارزقنا تلاوته آناء الليل وآناء النهار، واجعله لنا حجة يا رب العالمين. آمين. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Last night, as you must be remembering, we read the first 9 sections of Suratul Baqarah. Today we are starting with the 10th section. I think it will be beneficial if you recall a few things. I told you that this biggest surah of the Quran and the greatest surah as well, according to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, لكل شيء سنام وسنام القرآن سورة البقرة. Everything has a top, and the top of the Quran is سورة البقرة. It can be divided into 2 parts, nearly equal parts. In the first part, the address is basically to the former Muslim Ummah, that is Bani Israel. In the second part, the address is totally to the Muslim Ummah, present Muslim Ummah, that is the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first part comprises of 18 sections and 152 ayat, while the second part consists of 22 sections, but the number of ayat is 134. The first half then can be divided into 3 parts. The first 4 sections, they are preliminary. And I told you, it can be said that they contain a summary and gist of the whole of the Makki Quran, which was revealed before Suratul Baqarah. 2/3 of the Quran is Makki, and Suratul Baqarah was revealed at Medina. So actually 2/3 of the Quran had already been revealed. So a gist and summary of that has been placed in the beginning of Suratul Baqarah. Then 10 sections consist of direct address, Ya Bani Israel, Ya Bani Israel, Ya Ahl al-Kitab. This is the direct address to the former Muslim Ummah, that is Bani Israel. Then the 4 next sections, they may be called Tahwili, because the change of the direction of the Qibla in the prayer, which was a symbol of the change of the Ummah, that the former Muslim Ummah was deposed from that position which it occupied for 2,000 long years. and the new Muslim Ummah, that is the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is taking that place, is being installed in that position. Now the first four rukus also, although I told you that they are preliminary and they contain a gist and summary of the Makki Quran, but we find references toward the Jews in those four sections also. For example, you must be remembering that the second section, that is applicable equally to the Munafiqeen as well as the Jews. In the fourth section again, we find in the story of Iblis and Adam, a very subtle resemblance has been given that the attitude of the Jews of Medina towards Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the same as was the attitude of Iblis, Shaitan, towards Adam alayhi salatu wa salam. Because he also refused to prostrate before Adam alayhi salatu wa salam out of jealousy. There was no other reason. Out of his pride, because he was proud of himself. And he was jealous of Adam alayhi salatu wa salam. He didn't bow down as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded. The same was the case of the Jews. They recognized Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all right. They recognized him. يَعْرِفُونَهُ كَمَا يَعْرِفُونَ أَبْنَاهُمْ. This ayah we shall read today. But they didn't accept him, didn't believe in him. And that was also absolutely out of jealousy, sheer jealousy and nothing else. So there are subtle references towards Jews in those four sections also. Then you know, the address to the former Muslim Ummah, I told you, there must be made a very clear distinction that the first section, that is the fifth one, comprising of seven ayat, this consists of an invitation to the former Muslim Ummah to believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya bani Israel, askuru ni'mati allati anamtu alaykum, wa'ufu bi'ahdi, ufi bi'ahdikum, wa'iyaya farhabun, wa'amilu bima anzaltu musaddiqan liba ma'akum, wa la takunu awwala kafirin bih, wa la tashtaru bi'ayati samanan qalilan, wa'iyaya farhabun. From the next, that is the sixth section, now it's a very long charge sheet against the former Muslim Ummah that we are still studying. But while we are studying this charge sheet, one point must be kept in view. It is a charge sheet against the former Muslim Ummah, but it is also simultaneously a forewarning for the Muslim Ummah, for the new Muslim Ummah, the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. These were the wrong paths which were treaded by the former Muslim Ummah. They committed these mistakes. They went astray in such and such ways. Lest you should also, O Muslims, O Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, lest you should also follow the same path. You may go in their footsteps. So it was a forewarning to the Muslim Ummah. And let me quote here a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He once said to the companions, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, لَتَتَّبِعُنَّ سُنَنَ مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ. You will definitely follow in the footsteps of the former Muslim Ummah who were before you. قِيدَ شِبْرٍ بِشِبْرٍ وَيَدًا بِيَدٍ. Equally, each hand in place of a hand and each arm in place of an arm. It's, you know, a sort of muhawara, a usage in Arabic language to show the similarity of something. You will be following absolutely, completely the people who were before you. And if they entered the hole of a desert lizard, you will also enter it. And if there was someone from among the former Muslims who committed adultery with his mother, someone must be within you also who will do the same. Now the companions, you know, they were astonished and they asked, whom do you mean of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? A Yahud wal Nasara? And he replied, who else? You will follow in the footsteps of the Jews and the Christians. So actually we should see and we should read between the lines that the same things happened to the Muslims. The same wishful thinking. We are the blessed people. Because we are the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we must be saved. We cannot be kept in the fire of hell for all times to come, for eternity. All these things, you know, this, the same wishful thinking. Tilka amaniyuhum kul hatu burhanakum in kuntum sadiqeen. And let me quote here the ayah that comes in the end of the seventh section. Actually, this ayah is applicable to us today. And practically, it is not applicable to the Jews of today. ضُرِبَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ الزِّلَّةُ وَالْمَسْكَنَةُ وَبَعُوا بِغَضَبٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ. Humiliation was heaped upon them. And they got the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They were punished like anything. Are the Jews today getting the wrath of Allah? Are they humiliated in the world? They are controlling the sole supreme power on earth. The policies of the sole supreme power of earth is in the hands of the Jews, the Zionists. They are controlling the economy of the whole of the globe. Only about 14 or 15 million people. But you know the influence they have, how much authority they command in the whole of the world. While we, although we are more than a billion, but what's the condition? Humiliation. No say in the international affairs. Nobody concerns us. ضُرِبَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ الزِّلَّةُ وَالْمَسْكَنَةُ وَبَعُوا بِغَضَبٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ. These words depict the real condition of the Muslim Ummah today, not of the former Muslim Ummah. In the same way we read, you know, the last ayah that we studied last night, that people think that we cannot, the fire of hell will not touch us, save for a few days. لَنْ تَمَسَّلَ النَّارُ إِلَّا أَيَّامٌ مَعْدُودَةٌ. Now these are the same, you know, dogmas and aqidas that we have today. Because we are born Muslims, because we say kalma, so we shall anyhow be rescued and we shall be taken out. Even if we are thrown in the hell, we shall be taken out. Although a part of this is correct. If somebody has real iman, real faith, conviction in the heart, it is the agreed upon article of faith among the Muslims, all the sects of Muslims, that at one time he will be taken out from the hell. But that also, to the person who has a real faith, not just a verbal attestation. The verbal attestation was done by the munafiqeen of Medina. They also said the shahada, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. And Quran says that they will dwell in the fire of hell forever. إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ فِي الدَّرْكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ. So these are all things which we should understand, and now we proceed further. وَإِذْ أَخَذْنَا مِيثَاقَ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ. And just recall the time when we took the covenant from the children of Israel, the progeny of Israel, and that is Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salatu wassalam. What was that covenant? This ayah is very important. It gives the gist of the deen of Allah that has been the same from the very beginning. What are the basic articles of the deen of Allah? Number one, لَا تَعْبُدُونَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. You will not worship anybody, anything except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Number two, you must be respectful to and good in behavior towards your parents. Number three, وَذِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَى وَالْمَسَاكِينَ. And you should be doing good to your relatives and the orphans and the poor. Number four, وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنًا. Say to the people whatever is good. Talk to them gently. Enjoin them towards whatever is good. And as the reverse of it, forbid them from whatever is wrong, from whatever is evil and bad. Number five, وَاقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ. Establish this compulsory prayer five times a day. وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ. And pay the obligatory charity. Pay the zakah regularly. ثُمَّ تَوَلَّيْتُمْ. This was the covenant. This was the misaq. This misaq was taken by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the former Muslim Ummah. But now the charge is, ثُمَّ تَوَلَّيْتُمْ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا مِنْكُمْ. Then you turned your backs towards this misaq, towards this covenant. except a few among you. Only a few remained strict and true to this covenant. All of the rest abrogated. Bantum Moridun, while you were averse, you turned your backs and went away. Now another misaq. This was the basic misaq, you know, and this I told you is the gist of the deen of Allah. These are the headings under which you can count all the teachings of the deen of Allah. وَإِذْ أَخَذْنَا مِيثَاقَكُمْ لَا تَسْفِكُونَ دِمَاءَكُمْ. And just recall, when we took the covenant from you, you will not shed your blood. What does it mean? You will not shed the blood of each other, because you are one ummah. Now a person, an individual belonging to an ummah, if he kills a person belonging to the same ummah, it is as if he has shed his own blood. He has killed himself. لَا تَسْفِكُونَ دِمَاءَكُمْ. You will not shed the blood of each other. وَلَا تُخْرِجُونَ أَنفُسَكُمْ مِنْ دِيَارِكُمْ. And you will not expel each other from their homes, fighting each other. Because you know, after Hazrat Moses alayhi salatu wasalam, when Bani Israel entered Palestine, they conquered it. But they didn't establish one central government. They divided the whole country into 12 small states. Each tribe had its own state, small states. And then there was a quarrel. They were infighting. They were quarreling with each other. And then they were invoking and seeking the help of the others against each other. This is what happened in India. Before the Britishers came there, the whole of the country was divided into very small, you know, states. And they were fighting each other. And the Britishers took advantage of their enmities. And that is how they could conquer this big subcontinent. A few thousand of them, they conquered the whole of the country. Because there was infighting. So that happened for about 300 years after Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. They were divided among themselves. They had small states. They were fighting each other. And when someone attacked the other state, they expelled people from their state. So that they have been doing, although Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had forbidden them from doing so and taken the covenant. وَإِذَا خَزْنَا مِيثَاقَكُمْ لَا تَسْفِكُونَ دِمَاءَكُمْ وَلَا تُخْرِجُونَ أَنفُسَكُمْ مِنْ دِيَارِكُمْ ثُمَّ أَقْرَرْتُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ تَشْهَدُونَ. Then you promised that you will abide by this covenant, and you are witnesses to it, that you promised, you ratified the treaty, you ratified the covenant. ثُمَّ أَنْتُمْ هَؤُلَاءِ تَقْتُلُونَ أَنفُسَكُمْ. Then it is you who have been killing each other. وَتُخْرَجُونَ فَرِيقًا مِّنْكُمْ مِّنْ دِيَارِهِمْ. And expelling, turning out some of your people from their homes. وَتَظَاهَرُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِالْإِسْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ. And you have been having aggression on them and helping the enemies. تَظَاهَرُونَ مُزَاهَرَ بَابُ مُفَعَلَ. It is helping each other against someone. تَظَاهَرُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِالْإِسْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ. With sin and aggression. وَإِنْ يَعْتُوكُمْ أُسَارَى. There was another article of the covenant. That whenever you find a Jew with person of your own community as a captive anywhere, you must get him free by paying the ransom. This was again an article of the Sharia. Just as you know, it should be absolutely logical that if we find any Muslim in bondage, and he is captive somewhere, and we can afford to buy for him the freedom, to pay the money of ransom and get him free, we should do it as Muslims. So that was another article of the covenant that was taken from them. But now what happened? Now they were acting upon this article. When the same people whom they had themselves turned out from their homes, when they came to them as captives, now they remembered the covenant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh, we had promised that whenever we shall find a Jew in bondage or as a captive, we must get him free by paying the ransom. So they were paying the ransom and getting them free. Now this was their attitude. وَإِنْ يَاتُوكُمْ أُسَارَى تُفَادُوهُمْ وَهُوَ مُحَرَّمٌ عَلَيْكُمْ إِخْرَاجُهُمْ. Although it was banned for you, it was haram for you to expel them from their homes. Had you not expelled them from their homes, they would not have become captives. You expelled them, and here you contravened the covenant. But when they came as captives, now you are ransoming them. So actually, what does it mean? You are acting upon a part of the deen, part of the covenant, and you are breaking the other part. Now this is actually أَفَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِبَعْضِ الْكِتَابِ وَتَكْفُرُونَ بِبَعْضِ. These words are most profound. They are applicable to each of us today. Each of us. Not a single Muslim I can find at least who is free from this attitude. أَفَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِبَعْضِ الْكِتَابِ. So do you accept a part of our law, our book? وَتَكْفَرُونَ بِبَعْضِ. And reject the other? What are we doing today? Are we acting upon the whole of the deen? No. Part of the deen. Pray to Allah, pay the zakah. But go in business with interest. It's all right. Do everything which is haram. We are doing it. Not a single country in the whole of the Muslim world, although the number of the countries might be exceeding 50 or 60. Any country where there is no interest, no riba, none. The economy everywhere is based on riba. Any country where the deen of Allah is implemented in toto, none. So what are we doing? And you here are faithful to the American constitution. What is that constitution? Is it Islamic? At least I in Pakistan have a solace that in Pakistan constitution we have that objective resolution which declares the sovereignty is for Allah and the authority that we hold is a delegated authority only. At least this is there. Although these are words only, we are not practicing it. But you know, at least the words are there. Just as we utter the Shahada, Ashadu Allah, ilaha illallah, Ashadu Anna Muhammad Rasulullah, we are not practicing according to the Shahada. But we are Muslims on the basis of this Shahada. But the whole of the rest of the Muslim world, nowhere, the constitution doesn't provide it. That we accept Allah as our sovereign. Sovereignty belongs to Him. Sarwari zeba faqat us zaate behamta ko hai. Hukmara hai ik wahi baqi butane hazri. Nowhere. So this is very important. And you know the example is taken from the Jews, but the whole story is applicable to us. خُشْتَرَا بَاشَدْ كَسِرْرِ دِلْبَرَاً غُفْتَ آيَتْ دَرْ حَدِيثِ دِيگْرَاً. Story is of the older Ummah, but actually it's applicable fully to the present Muslim Ummah. أَفَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِبَعْضِ الْكِتَابِ وَتَكْفُرُونَ بِبَعْضِ. So do you accept and believe in part of the book, part of the Sharia? And you reject and disbelieve the rest of it. فَمَا جَزَاءُ مَنْ يَفْعَلُ ذَلِكَ مِنْكُمْ. So there can be no punishment for those who take to this attitude from amongst you. إِلَّا خِزْيٌ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. Except that they should be put to extreme humiliation in the world, in this world, in the life of this world. And that is what we are experiencing. Extreme humiliation. Why? ہے آج کیوں ذلیل کے کل تک نہ تھی پسند گستاخی فرشتہ ہماری جناب میں. Why? At least there's a cause, and the cause is the same. Because we have accepted the faith, Islam, deen, only partially. إِلَّا خِزْيٌ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةَ يُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ أَشَدِّ الْعَذَابِ. On the day of judgment, they will be thrown in the worst punishment, in the most grievous torment. وَمَنْ لَاهُ بِغَافِلٍ أَمَّا تَعَمَلُونَ. And don't think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is unawares of what you are doing. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ اشْتَرَوُوا الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا بِالْآخِرَةِ. They are the people who have purchased this life of this world in exchange for the life of hereafter. They have given away the life of hereafter and they have preferred and chosen the life of this world. فَلَا يُخَفَّفُ عَنْهُمُ الْعَذَابِ. So the torment shall not be lightened or decreased for them. وَلَا هُمْ يُنْصَرُونَ Nor they will be able to get any help from anyway. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ وَقَفَّيْنَا مِنْ بَعْدِهِ بِالرُّسُلِ And verily, we gave to Moses the book, that is Torah. وَقَفَّيْنَا مِنْ بَعْدِهِ بِالرُّسُلِ And we followed him up with a succession of messengers, prophets after prophets, a chain, continuous chain of prophets after Moses till Jesus. For 1400 long years, this chain of prophethood never broke. There's a hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari. The prophet says, كُلَّمَا حَلَكَ نَبِيٌّ خَلَفَهُ نَبِيٌّ كَانَتْ بَنُو إِسْرَائِيلْ تَسْوُسَهُمُ الْأَنْبِيَاءَ كُلَّمَا حَلَكَ نَبِيٌّ خَلَفَهُ نَبِيٌّ The community affairs and the political affairs of Bani Israel were in the hands of the prophets. Whenever a prophet died, another prophet was the caliph. He took his place. So continuous change. ثُمَّ قَفَّيْنَا مِنْ بَعْدِهِ بِالرُّسُلِ And now the last, end of the chain. وَآتَيْنَا عِيسَى ابْنَ مَرْيَمَ الْبَيِّنَاتِ And we gave to Jesus, to Isa, son of Mary, Maryam, عليهما الصلاة والسلام البينات clear signs, clear proofs and here it means the miracles the biggest miracles you know which can be seen through these senses they were given to Hazrat Masih عليه الصلاة والسلام بيناه بروح القدس and we supported him and helped him with the pure spirit of روح القدس and it means Hazrat Jibreel عليه الصلاة والسلام أَفَكُلَّمَا جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ So what? Whenever there came a Rasul, there came a prophet, بِمَا لَا تَهْوَى أَنفُسُكُمْ With something that you didn't like, your souls didn't approve, with some teaching which was not liked by you, اسْتَكْبَرْتُمْ You became arrogant. You didn't accept. فَفَرِيقًا كَذَّبْتُمْ some of those prophets, you only belied them. You only disbelieved them. فَفَرِيقًا تَقْتُلُونَ And some of them you have been killing and murdering. As you know, they murdered Hazrat Yahya alayhi salatu wasalam, John the Baptist, the cry from the wilderness according to the Bible. Hazrat Yahya alayhi salam. And he was killed by the Jew king of that time. And the Jews, they decreed that Jesus must be hanged, crucified. Although it's a different story what Allah Ta'ala did with him. But they at least tried to do the same. They killed in the same manner Hazrat Zakariya alayhi salatu wasalam. فَفَرِيقًا كَذَّبْتُمْ وَفَرِيقًا تَقْتُلُونَ And I told you there is a long charge sheet against our Jews, against the former Muslim Ummah. As a result of which they were deposed from that position, high position. وَقَالُوا قُلُوبُنَا غُلْفٌ And they said, actually, in mocking at the Muslims and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قُلُوبُنَا غُلْفٌ Our hearts are wrapped up. Our hearts are secure. What did they mean by this? Well, your preaching will have no effect on us. Don't think you can convince us. Keep your preaching with you. It's not going to affect our hearts. Our hearts are fortified. You know, they are secure. قُلُوبُنَا غُلْفٌ Now, what are the comments by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? بَلَّعَنَهُمُ اللَّهُ بِكُفْرِهِمْ Actually, the condition is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has cursed them. They are under the curse and lana of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بِكُفْرِهِمْ Due to their disbelieving. فَقَلِيلًا مَّا يُؤْمِنُونَ And it is correct. That a very few among them will come to believe and join this ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ كِتَابٌ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ And when a book came to them from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now although this is a generalized word, it can mean Quran also. It can mean Injil also. Whenever a book came to them. But you know most of the Mufassirin think that here Quran is being mentioned. وَلَمَّا جَاءُ كِتَابٌ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ When a book from Allah has come to them, مُصَدِّقٌ لِمَا مَعَهُمْ And it is confirming that which is with them. It is accepting the Torah was also book of Allah, which he gave to Moses. وَكَانُوا مِنْ قَبْلُ يَسْتَفْتِحُونَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. And they were at the, before that time, they were invoking Allah's blessings, that that last prophet now should be sent, so that with his help, we can defeat our enemies, we can defeat the disbelievers, عَلَى الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Because they had this tradition in their books, that when the last prophet would come, then you know his deen will be supreme over all the other religions. So they were waiting. And they used to say to the people of Aus and Khazraj in Medina, that presently you can defeat us. But you know when that prophet comes, we shall fight you being his companions. With his help we shall defeat you. But when that prophet came, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, فَلَمَّا جَاهُمْ مَا عَرَفُوا. When he came to them, whom they recognized, that he is the prophet for whom we were waiting. He is that prophet. مَا عَرَفُوا كَفَرُوا بِهِ. But they disbelieved him, they rejected him, they refused to believe in him. فَلَعْنَةُ اللَّهِ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ. Again the same comments from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So there is curse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on these disbelievers. بِيْسَمَا اشْتَرَوْا بِهِ أَنفُسَهُمْ. Bad is the thing for which they have bartered their souls. أَنْ يَكْفُرُوا بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ بَغْيًا. That they are disbelieving, they are rejecting that thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent down. They are rejecting Quran. They are rejecting Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the reason of rejecting is baghyan an yunazzil Allahu min fadli ala man yasha'u min ibadihi. Grudging that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent down this blessing to whom he willed, to whom he chose. He thought that that prophet will also be from among the Jews. They thought. They thought because after, you know, Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, all the prophets came in the progeny of Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam, excepting only one or two. The only exceptions are Hazrat Shuaib alayhi salatu wasalam, Hazrat Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam. All the rest of the prophets and messengers, they came in the progeny, in the children, in the tribes that were raised from the children of Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam. So they thought that this is our exclusive proprietorship. This will remain with us. And the last prophet will also be from among us, from amongst us. But when Allah chose Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was from Bani Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam. He was not you. He was not from the progeny of Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam. So that was the only reason, baghyan, they were grudging it. أَنْ يُنَزِّلَ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ عَلَىٰ مَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent down from His blessings to whom He liked from His bondsmen. فَبَاءُوا بِغَضَبٍ عَلَىٰ غَضَبٍ. So they drew upon themselves wrath after wrath from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِلْكَافِرِينَ عَذَابٌ مُهِينٌ. And for these disbelievers who have rejected the deen of Allah, who have rejected Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who have rejected Quran, for them is a punishment which is disgracing. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ آمِنُوا بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ. And when it is said to them, come to believe what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent down. قَالُوا نُؤْمِنُوا بِمَا أُنزِلَ عَلَيْنَا. They say, we believe only on those things which were sent to us. وَيَكْفُرُونَ بِمَا وَرَاهُ. And they disbelieve and reject the rest. Everything that is beyond it. All that was given to us, to Moses, to all the Hebrew prophets. Only we accept that. We need nothing more. They are disbelieving the rest. وَهُوَ الْحَقُّ مِنْ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا مَعَهُمْ. Although it is the truth. This Quran is the truth. This has been sent down by the same Allah who sent down Torah and Injil. And مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا مَعَهُمْ. And it is confirming that which is with them, that is Torah and Injil. قل فلم تقتلون انبیاء اللہ من قبل ان کنتم یؤمنین. Now Muhammad asked them, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, why have you been killing the prophets? You say whatever was given to our prophets, we believe in it. But this is your history. You yourself tell that you killed Yahya alayhi salatu wa salam, you killed Zakariya alayhi salatu wa salam. So why have you been killing the and murdering the prophets of Allah? In kuntum mu'mineen, if you are truthful, if you are believers, if you believed in them, if you believed in the books that were sent on them, why did you kill them? وَلَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مُوسَى بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ. And Musa had come to you with clear proofs and signs. ثُمَّ تَخَسْتُمُ الْعِجْلَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ. But when he left, you took to the worship of Kaaf. وَأَنْتُمْ ظَالِمُونَ. And you were very unjust. You were the polytheists. You became mushrik and murtad. وَإِذَا خَذْنَا مِيثَاقَكُمْ وَرَفَعْنَا فَوْقَكُمُ الطُّورَ. And recall again the moment when we took the covenant from you and we raised the bound over your heads. خُذُوا مَا آتَيْنَاكُمْ بِقُوَّةٍ. And we said, now hold fast to what we have given to you with your full force, بِقُوَّةٍ. Hold fast to it. Now you must cling to this Torah that we have given you. This Sharia that has been given to you. خُذُوا مَا آتَيْنَاكُمْ بِقُوَّةٍ وَاسْمَعُوا. And keep listening. قَالُوا سَمِعْنَا وَعَصَيْنَا. The usual word after سَمِعْنَا is أَطَعْنَا. They should have said, we have listened and we have accepted. We listen and we accept. And we submit. But now they change the word أَطَعْنَا to أَصَيْنَا. Now that was the mischief in them. They said, we listened and we disobeyed. We listened and we rejected. قَالُوا سَمِعْنَا وَعَصَيْنَا وَأُشْرِبُوا فِي قُلُوبِهِمُ الْعِجْلِ. And this worship and sanctification of the calf went down deep into their hearts. بِكُفْرِهِمْ due to their disbelief. قُلْ بِعْسَ مَا يَعْمُرُكُمْ بِهِ إِمَانُكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Tell them, how bad is the thing which your iman is teaching you? If you are, you claim mu'min, to be mu'min, is this the attitude that the iman should take? You have been worshipping kaf. قُلْ إِن كَانَتْ لَكُمُ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ خَالِصَةً مِّن دُونِ النَّاسِ فَتَمَنَّبُوا الْمَوْتَ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you really think that the house of the hereafter is reserved for you, leaving others of humanity. They said, we are the exclusive, you know. We hold exclusive rights over paradise, over Jannah, just as we think today. We are the exclusive, you know, right holders. And each one of us thinks that he has a reserved seat in Jannah because he is a Muslim. Because by mere accident of birth, he was born to Muslim parents. That's all. And such a big difference will happen for the eternal life. And because due to an accident of birth, some was born Hindu, some was born Christian, they must go to the hell permanently. And because we were born Muslim, it was not none of our choice, none of our, you know, some exertion in it, nothing of the sort, no sacrifice. But we claim to be, to having the exclusive proprietary rights. قُلْ إِن كَانَتْ لَكُمُ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ خَالِصَةً مِّن دُونِ النَّاسِ. If you really believe so, then you should long for death, not for this life. If somebody really thinks, if somebody really is convinced that he has a place in paradise, will he like to live in this world for even a single day? It's simple logic. If he is convinced. قُلْ إِن كَانَتْ لَكُمُ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ خَالِصَةً مِّن دُونِ النَّاسِ فَتَمَنَّبُوا الْمَوْتَ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. If you are really truthful, if you really believe in it, then you should long for death. وَلَنْ يَتَمَنَّاهُ أَبَدًا. This is the comment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they are never going to long for death. وَلَنْ يَتَمَنَّوْهُ أَبَدًا بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ. Due to the deeds that their both hands have sent forward before them, they know what are our kartoots, what we have done, what our both hands have earned up till now, what we have deposited in the bank of the hereafter. We know it. So actually, none of them wanted to go there, and none of us wants to go there, because we know what we have sent before us. وَلَنْ يَتَمَنَّهُ أَبَدًا بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِالظَّالِمِينَ. And Allah very well knows these evildoers, these unjust people. وَلَتَجِدَنَّهُمْ أَحْرَسَ النَّاسِ عَلَىٰ حَيَاةٍ. And you will find them, definitely, surely, the greediest people for this life. فَمِنَ الَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا. Even more greedy than these people, the idolaters, the pagan Arabs. يَوَدُّ أَحَدُهُمْ لَوْ يُعَمَّرُ أَلْفَ سَنَةٍ. Each one of them longs and wishes to be living in this world for 1,000 years. وَمَا هُوَ بِمُزَحْزِحِهِ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ أَنْ يُعَمَّرُ. Although, even if someone's life here is very long, and he is granted a very long life here, this cannot save him from the fire of hell. If his deeds are bad, he will go there. Even if he dies after 1,000 years, where will he go? He will go to the hell. So it's no escape. It's no saving. وَاللَّهُ بَصِيرٌ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ. And Allah is seeing what they are doing. قُلْ مَنْ كَانَ عَدُوًّا لِجِبْرِيلَ فَإِنَّهُ نَزَّلَهُ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ. Now as we have seen, although they recognized Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they knew that Quran is true, they only disbelieved because Muhammad was not a Jew, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was not from amongst them. And they were angry. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has snatched from us this institution of prophethood? It had been with us, this grace of Allah, this blessing of Allah, it was with us for at least 1400 years. Why has it been snatched from us? Now the same, due to the same reason, they were angry with Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam. Because he brought the wahi to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is our enemy. Actually, now they became the enemies of Jibreel. Just as you know, there has been a small section of Ahl al-Tashayyu who are called Ghurabiya. They have the belief, Hazrat Mujaddid al-Fisani rahmatullah alayh mentioned them in his makatib, in his letters. They believe that actually prophethood was aimed for Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, not for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Jibreel by mistake took the wahi to Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It was by mistake only. Because the spirits and souls of Ali and Muhammad were very similar. Therefore, he just was mistaken. He couldn't recognize. Actually, the wahi was meant for Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and mistakenly Jibreel took it to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But till this, that is their belief. The same was the case with the Jews. They thought that it is actually the action of Jibreel, the decision of Jibreel, that he took that wahi that was meant for some one of us to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from the progeny of Ismail. قُلْ مَنْ كَانَ عَدُوًّا لِجِبْرِيلِ فَإِنَّهُ نَزَّلَهُ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. Tell them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whosoever is an enemy to Jibreel, he must know that he has sent down, brought down this wahi to your heart, O Muhammad, with the permission and command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not in his own. مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ. And this has been sent down, confirming that which is present with them before it, that is Torah and Injil. وَهُدَمْ وَبُشْرَىٰ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And it is the guidance and it is the glad tidings for all the mu'mineen, for all who believe. مَنْ كَانَ عَدُوًّا لِلَّهِ وَمَلَائِكَتِهِ. Whosoever is an enemy to Allah and His angels, وَرُسُلِهِ, and His messengers and prophets, وَجِبْرِيلَ وَمِيكَالَ. And Jibreel and Mikael, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ عَدُوٌّ لِلْكَافِرِينَ. He should know that Allah is enemy to all such disbelievers. They are actually challenging Allah. They are getting the enmity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in reward. وَلَقَدْ أَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ آيَاتٍ بَيِّنَاتٍ And we have sent down to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, these clear ayat. وَمَا يَكْفُرُ بِهَا إِلَى الْفَاسِقُونَ And nobody except the transgressors or rebellious in nature will disbelieve these ayat. These are so clear and so very self-evident that only those who are rebellious in nature, they will only disbelieve them. أَوَكُلَّمَا أَهَدُوا أَهَدًا نَبَذَهُ فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ Is it not that whenever they ratified a treaty, ratified a covenant, نَبَذَهُ فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ A group from them, a part from them, they threw it away, threw it aside. بَلَكْسَرُهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ But most of them don't believe actually. They are in a community of Bani Israel. They are a race. It's a racial religion. All people who belong to that race think that they are Jews. They are Mu'mins. While ever, only a few of them are real Mu'mins. أَكْسَرُهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ Most of them, the great majority of them, don't have that faith. The same case is with us today. Out of the billion, more than a billion Muslims, how many have real faith, real conviction, real belief in Allah and the hereafter and the day of judgment and the institution of Wahi? How many of us? So that was the case of the former Ummah. Al-aksarahum la yuminun. Walamma ja'ahum rasulun min indillah. And when a messenger from Allah came to them, musaddiqul lima ma'ahum, again the same verse, confirming that which was already present with them, that is Torah and Injil. نَبَذَ فَرِيقٌ مِّنَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَرَاءَ ظُهُورِهِمْ A party, a group of those who were given the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before this Qur'an, they threw this book, this new book of Allah, Qur'an, on their backs. كَانَّهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ As if they don't know, they don't recognize. Although they knew, they recognized. يَعْرِفُونَهُ كَمَا يَعْرِفُونَ أَبْنَاهُمْ They recognized it just as they recognized their own sons. But they apparently took the attitude of throwing it away. No, nothing. It's nothing. So actually, that was their apparent attitude. وَاتَّبَعُوا مَا تَتْلُوا الشَّيَاطِينُ عَلَى مُلْكِ سُلَيْمَانِ Now, if you leave something that is correct, then necessarily something wrong comes in its place. When they gave up following the book of Allah, they started pursuing other occult sciences. Sorcery, magic, all these things, you know, that are very common among some Muslims also, the ignorant Muslim also. So Taweez, Gande, sorcery and magic and this and that. So these become, you know, articles of interest with those people who don't have the real deen before them. But Tabau, when they threw back on their backs the books of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the real guidance, what did they pursue? وَاتَّبَعُوا مَا تَتْلُوا الشَّيَاطِينُ عَلَى مُلْكِ سُلَيْمَانِ And they followed what the shayateen, they were pursuing or reciting in the days of the kingdom of Solomon, Sulaiman alayhi salatu wassalam. وَمَا كَفَرَ سُلَيْمَانُ وَلَكِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ كَفَرُوا All this magic you will find goes in the name of Sulaiman, نَخْشِ سُلَيْمَانِ You know, the ta'weez. As if all these things, you know, they originated from Hazrat Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam. Quran says, no, وَمَا كَفَرَ سُلَيْمَانِ This sorcery and magic, it is kufr. How could Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam commit kufr? وَمَا كَفَرَ سُلَيْمَانِ وَلَكِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ كَفَرُوا These were the shayateen. During his days, because, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him the control over jinns. And among the jinns, there were Muslims also and shayateen also. So although they were under the control of Sulaiman, but they had their own creed. They had their own privileges, priorities. And they spread among the Jews of those days their own teachings and their own practices. And this is how this magic and sorcery, you know, that permeated the whole Jewish society. وَمَا أُنزِلَ عَلَى الْمَلَكَيْنِ بِبَابِلَ هَارُوتَ وَمَارُوتَ. And this is the sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that when something wrong, you know, becomes prevalent in a society, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts that society to some big test and trial. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down two angels, Harut and Marut. وَمَا أُنزِلَ عَلَى الْمَلَكَيْنِ بِبَابِلَ. In Babylon, and that was the days of the captivity of the Jews, when Nebuchadnezzar had destroyed Jerusalem and took so many of them as captives to Babylonia, Babel. And there actually, during that captivity period, the sorcery and magic and all these things, these occult sciences, they became very prevalent. وَمَا أُنزِلَ عَلَى الْمَلَكَيْنِ بِبَابِلَ هَارُوتَ وَمَارُوتَ وَمَا يُعَلِّمَانِ مِنْ أَحَدٍ حَتَّى يَقُولَ. And these both angels, in the form of men, they never taught anybody this, that sihr and magic and sorcery, but they said beforehand, إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ فِتْنَةٌ. We are a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are a trial for you. فَلَا تَكْفُرْ. You don't commit kufr. You don't try to learn this sihr, this magic and this sorcery. فَيَتَوَلَّمُونَ مِنْهُمَا. Despite this warning from those angels, they learned from them مَا يُفَرِّقُونَ بِهِ بَيْنَ الْمَرْءِ وَزَوْجِهِ. That thing with which they could separate the husband from the wife. Separation, causing separation between the wives and the husbands. وَمَا هُمْ بِضَارِّينَ بِهِ مِنْ أَحَدٍ. Although the real fact is that they couldn't do any harm to anybody except with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing can happen without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is an article of faith. No food can do any good to you, no medicine can do any good to you without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All the things, you know, they have all the minerals and all the compounds, they have their own properties. But these properties can't come into actual effect without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So even magic, by itself it cannot do anything, but with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ وَيَتَعَلَّمُونَ مَا يَضُرُّهُمْ. And they used to learn from them what harmed them, وَلَا يَنْفَعُهُمْ, and was not beneficial to them. وَلَقَدْ عَلِمُوا. Although they very well knew, it was made plain to them, it was clear to them in Torah. لَمَنِ اشْتَرَاهُ مَا لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ خَلَاقٍ. Whosoever will pursue this sorcery and magic, whosoever will purchase it, whosoever will adopt it, for him there is no share in the hereafter. مَا لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ خَلَاقٍ مِنْ خَلَاقٍ وَبِئْسَ مَا شَرَوْا بِهِ أَنفُسَهُمْ. But indeed, it was very bad for which they sold their own souls. لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ. Only if they could know. Actually, they didn't know what they are doing, what harm they are doing to themselves by taking to these pursuits, by adopting these lines and these attitudes. They were actually throwing themselves with their own hands into the fire of hell. وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ آمَنُوا. And had they came to believe, if they had the real belief, if they really believed, لَمَسُوبَةٌ مِّنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ. Then the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have been much better for them. Had they struck to the right path, had they followed the book of Allah instead of these practices of shayateen, this magic and sorcery, instead of these things, had they followed the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, had they followed the truth and the straight path, لَمَسُوبَةٌ مِّنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ, then the reward that they would have got from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have been much better. Much better. لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ. Only if they could know, only if they had the real knowledge. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.